Okay. Factor responsible for deterioration of harvested fruits and vegetables. So there are different factors are responsible for deterioration of harvested fruits and vegetables. In that one, first primary causes, and second one is the some of the secondary causes and sub site of losses. So first is primary causes of loss. Those are directly affects on food enzymic changes. These are the four primary causes. Enzymatic changes. Enzymes which are indigenous to plant tissue can have undesirable or desirable consequence. So the enzymes are endogenous to plant tissue. The enzymes are indigenous, that is already present in the plant tissue, and that can affects on fruits and vegetables life after the harvest. So examples involving enzymic changes include the post-harvest spoilage of fruits and vegetables. Then oxidation of phenolic substances in a plant tissue by phenolase leading to browning. After the harvesting, some of the fruits are leading to browning condition. So because of the enzymes are present in the fruits or vegetables. Then starch, sugar, conversion in plant tissue by amylase. These all the enzymes are responsible for deterioration of fruits and vegetables. Then post-harvest deamylation of pectic substances in the plant tissue leading to softening of plant tissue during the ripening and firmness of the tissue during the processing. Okay, some of the fruits are soft after the harvest, harvesting after 2 to 3 days because of the enzymes. Okay. Then the major factors useful in controlling enzymic activities are temperature, water activity, pH, and chemicals which can inhibit the enzymic action. So this is the factors are useful for controlling the enzymatic activities. So the deterioration can be reduced of the fruits and vegetables after the harvesting. Then chemical changes. First, sensory quality. The two major chemical change which occur during the processing and storage of food and lead to deterioration in sensory quality are lipid oxidation and non-enzymic browning. So sensory, that means the sense or smell, taste, okay, taste of the fruits and vegetables change after the harvesting due to the chemical change. Okay, some of the fruits and vegetables having enzymatic browning after the harvesting. Okay, the chemical reaction are responsible for change in the color and flavor of the food during the processing and storage. The lipid oxidation rates and course of reaction is influenced by light, local oxygen concentration, high temperature, and the presence of catalyst. Generally, transition metals such as iron and copper and water activity. Okay, due to the lipid oxidation, okay, lipid is the enzyme. Lipid oxidation rate and course of reaction is influenced by light, local oxygen concentration, high temperature, and presence of catalyst. Okay, these are the factors that are also responsible for the enzymic activity. Control of these factors can significantly reduce the extent of lipid oxidation in the foods. Non-enzymic browning is one of the major cause of deterioration which occurs during the storage of dried and concentrated foods. Then color change. Almost any type of food processing or storage cause some deterioration of chlorophyll pigments. The reaction is accelerated by heat and acid catalyst. After the harvesting or cutting off fruits, the color is lost due to the deterioration of chlorophyll pigment. So that's why the color change occur in the fruits and vegetables after the harvest. The reaction is accelerated by heat and acid catalyze. Okay, heat, that means the temperature level, temperature of harvested, temperature condition of the harvested fruits and vegetables. And acid catalyze, this is the internal process of fruits and vegetables, acid catalyze. So that's why chemical change, color changes is occur in fruits and vegetables. Okay, then next one is the flavor changes. You know, fruit and vegetables, enzymically generated compounds derived from long chain fatty acids play an extremely important role in the formation of characteristic flavor. Number of fruits having the different flavors of because of the enzymes are present on the in that of fruits and vegetables. So the flavor derived from long chain fatty acids. Okay, fruits having a flavor due to the long chain fatty acid and extremely important role in the formation of characteristics of flavors. Okay, in addition, this type of reaction can lead to significant of flavors. The permeability of packaging material is of importance in retaining desirable volatile compounds within packages and or in permitting undesirable compounds to permit through the package from the ambient atmosphere. So the packaging material is also responsible for deterioration of fruits, flowers, and vegetables after the harvest. Nutritional quality. The major four major factors which affect the nutrient degradation and can be controlled to varying extents by packaging are first light, oxygen concentration, temperature, and water activity. Okay, then these are the chemical changes, and second one is the physical change. One major undesirable physical change in a food is absorption of moisture as a consequence of an inadequate barrier provided by the package. The results in cracking it can occur either as a result of poor selection of packaging material in the first place or the failure of the packaging integrity during the storage. In general, moisture absorption is associated with increased the cohesiveness. Okay, so physical changes occur due to the fruits and vegetables due to the packaging material. Which type of packaging material are used for the storage of products? Okay, if the packaging material is a low quality, so the package, so the deterioration of fruits and vegetables is very fast. So it's very necessary to use a high level or the high quality packaging material for the storage. Okay. Then biological changes, microbiological changes. In that one, there are two types of biological changes because of the some of the microbiological organism and some of the macrobiological organism. Okay. First one, microbiological. Microorganism can make both desirable and undesirable change due to the quality of foods, depending on the whether or not they are introduced as an essential part of the food preservation process, or arise the unintentionally and the subsequently grow to produce food spoilage. There are two groups of microorganisms found in the foods are bacteria and fungi. Okay, so microorganism, microbiological organism, though two groups, first bacteria and second one is the fungi, the latter consisting of yeast and molds. So, and the minor infection is yeast and molds. The bacteria are generally the fastest growing, so that the condition favorable to both bacteria will usually outgrow fungi. Okay, now the bacteria is the fastest growing, or the bacteria is responsible for the deterioration of fruits and vegetables or the spoilage of fruits. Foods are frequently classified on the basis of stability as non-perishable, semi-perishable, and perishable. The foods are classified in the three categories. First is non-perishable. semi perishable and perishable. So some of the fruits, for example, strawberry is a perishable. Okay, then semi perishable, for example, wood apple, it is non perishable. And semi perishable, for example, apple, apple or pear, peach, etc. Okay, so perishable, that means the fruit having the 2 to 3 life after the harvest, 2 to 3 days life after the harvesting, that means the short shelf life. Semi perishable is the having partially long shelf life, and non perishable, that means the it can be stored for a longer period. The protection of packaged food from contamination or the attack by microorganism depends on the mechanical integrity of the package. Example, the absence of breaks or seal imperfections, and on the resistance of the package to the penetration by microorganism. So, packaging material is very important for the fruits, storing of fruits and vegetables or the food products, to protect the fruits and vegetables from the contamination of microorganism or attack of microorganism. Secondary causes of loss. Microbiological factors. First is the insect and pest. Warm, humid environment promote insect growth, although most of the insect will not be breed if the temperature exceed about 35 degrees Celsius or falls below the 10 degrees Celsius. So insect and pest is also responsible for the deterioration of fruits and vegetables. Like most of the insect and pest cannot be breed to the if the temperature is exceed 35 degrees Celsius or below 10 degrees Celsius. Okay, so also many insects cannot reproduce satisfactorily unless the moisture content of their food is greater than about 11%. Okay, if the moisture content is greater than 11%, the insect or pest cannot be reproduced. Okay. Reproduce satisfactorily. Okay. And then rodent, rats and mice carry the disease producing organism on their feet and are in their intestinal tracts, and are known to Herbaria, Salmonella and serotypes frequently associated with foodborne infection in humans. So the rats is also responsible for the deterioration of fruits and vegetables. These are the primary causes, and next one is the secondary causes of loss. This leads to condition that encourage the primary cause of loss, such as first, inadequate harvesting, packaging and handling skill. Due to the inadequate harvesting, packaging and handling of the fruits and vegetables, the deterioration of fruits and vegetables is also depends. Lack of adequate containers for the transport and handling of perishable. So the container or the packaging material is also responsible. We already seen in the primary causes. So if the lack of adequate containers for the transport and handling of perishable, that also responsible for the deterioration of fruits and flowers, vegetables like. Then storage facilities inadequate to protect the food. Then transportation inadequate to move the food to market before it spoils. Transport facilities, if the transport facilities is good or the adequate, that can be food can be stored for food can be safe from the spoilage to the market. Then inadequate refrigerated storage. Okay, due to the lack of refrigerated storage, most of the product is spoiled. Inadequate drying equipments or poor drying season. drying material, a dryer is required for the some of the fruits and vegetables drying. So if it is inadequate or the lack of drying equipments, the fruits and vegetables can be spoiled. Then traditional processing and marketing system canals can be responsible for high losses. Then legal standard can affect the retention or rejection of food for the human use. Some of the standards are required for the retention or rejection of fruits and flowers. That means and also that standard is clarify for the use of human. So that's why if the legal standard cannot be adopted for the storing of fruits and flowers or the vegetables, so this product or the fruits and vegetables are not not useful for the human. Knowledge of management is essential for the maintaining tools in a good condition during marketing and storage. It is very necessary to know about or the knowledge about the maintaining knowledge about condition or the tool required for the marketing and storage of a product. Bumper crops can be overloaded the post-harvest handling system or exceed the consumption needs and cause excessive wastage. So it is necessary to use of the harvested fruits and vegetables if there is a gulf amount. So that can be useful for the processing. So the wastage can be reduced. Next one is the site loss, site of losses. Losses may occur anywhere from the point where the food has been harvested or gathered up to the point of consumption. Loss occurs during one of the following processes. After the harvesting or gathered of fruits and vegetables in a point of consumption. So which type of losses can be occur? So the first one is the harvest. The separation of commodity from the plant that produce it. Okay, harvesting, proper harvesting is required for the fruits and vegetables. Then preparation, the preliminary separation or extraction of the edible from the non-edible portion. Then preservation, the prevention of loss and spoilage of the food. For example, the sun drying of fruit, the use of refrigeration, and the use of fungicides to inhibit mold growths in the fruits. Okay, preservation after the harvesting, it is very necessary to store the fruits or the vegetables in a refrigerator or can we use fungicide treatment to inhibit the mold growth. Then processing, the conversion of edible food into the another form more acceptable or more convenient to the consumer. For example, the manufacture of fruit juice and the canning of fruits and vegetables. Okay. Most of the edible fruits, most of the fruits and vegetables can be used for the processing, for making the juice, canning of fruits and vegetables. Okay. The storage, the holding of food until consumption. Most of storage is common storage, ambient temperature, but there are extensive storage capacity that can hold the food under refrigerator or controlled atmosphere condition. So proper storage facilities are required for the storing of fruits and vegetables. There are different types of storage. For example, modified atmospheric storage are also available, then controlled atmospheric storage. Proper or the cold storage is also available for the storing of fruits and vegetables. So that can be increase the shelf life of that fruits and vegetables. Then transportation, all forms of transportation are used to convey the food from the point of production to the ultimate point of consumption. Transportation facilities are very important to transport the fruits and vegetables quickly to the point of consumption. Okay, so these are the These are all about the factors responsible for deterioration of fruits and vegetables.